Our sun has always gazed light upon us and has always been staring at us ever since the creation. Amidst this COVID-19 pandemic lockdown, our sun has been watching us, all of us being locked down and quarantined. So maybe the sun thought, I want to be a part of it too. But if the sun goes in lockdown, there could be drought, famine, and all sorts of environmental harms, right? Nah, it's just a usual cycle that sun undergoes. So what is happening? Let's see. Well, sun lockdown. Technically, it's not a lockdown. It's just called solar minimum in space terms. In order to understand this, we need to understand a couple of more things. Solar cycle and sunspots. So first, what is a solar cycle? Our sun is a huge ball of electrically charged hot gas, and these generate powerful magnetic field around the sun. This magnetic field keeps moving on the surface of the sun and the poles shift upside down. North pole goes to the south and the south to the north. This process takes 11 years to complete, and this is called the solar cycle. This cycle keeps repeating for every 11 years, flipping the north and the south poles. The first solar cycle was recorded in 1755, and right now we are in the middle of a solar cycle 24 and solar cycle 25. Between every solar cycle, during the transition period, sun's magnetic field becomes weak and we can see some dark spots on the surface of the sun where there are less magnetic field, so the surface of the sun is quite visible. These dark spots are called as sunspots. Sunspots are due to reduced magnetic fields and are called as solar minimum. So that is what a solar lockdown is actually. When they have extreme magnetic fields, there are eruptions on the surface of the sun, and this takes place in the middle of the solar cycle, and that is called as a solar maximum. So the transition between a solar cycle 24 and the solar cycle 25 should be happening around April 2020, with approximately a plus or minus 6 months. During the solar minimum, if the sunspots are large enough, they could be visible to the naked eye. So should we be worried? Well, no. This is just the nature of the sun, and it has been happening for a long time. So what else could happen? Well, since the magnetic field of the sun is weak during this time, more cosmic rays could enter the solar system, which could be a health hazard for astronauts and polar air travelers. Few scientists believe that there could be a grand solar maximum, where the temperature could rise in the next few decades, because the last solar cycle, 24, was of less magnitude. Even if there is a grand solar maximum, scientists believe it wouldn't bring much of an impact on the Earth's climate. But that doesn't mean there wouldn't be any impact at all. The warming caused by the greenhouse gas emissions by us, humans, would be 6 times greater than the decades of cooling caused by the solar minimum. So, the solar maximum, will it be causing any climate issues? Nope. It's the fossil fuels we humans burn down on the surface of the Earth that's causing the climate change. So, is the sun lockdown a problem? Should we be worried about it? Nope, not at all. Solar minimum is not at all a problem.